Welcome to 2230, your source for insightful news updates and inspiring stories. Today, we bring you a detailed coverage of a heartwarming initiative by Singapore's Minister for Education, Chan Chun Sing, as he lends a helping hand to Periathambi Senthil Murugan, affectionately known as Sam, the owner of Thumbi Magazine Store in Holland Village. Join us as we explore the efforts to preserve community heritage and support local businesses. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more uplifting content. In a recent Facebook post, Minister for Education Chan Chun Sing shared an inspiring story of community support and resilience. The focus of his post was on Periathambi Senthil Murugan, also known as Sam, the owner of the beloved Thumbi Magazine store in Holland Village, which recently closed its doors after more than 80 years of operation. Minister Chan revealed that he is actively involved in assisting Sam in finding an alternative location for his iconic newsstand. The closure of Thumbi Magazine store on May 5 marked the end of an era for the Holland Village community. For over 8 decades, the newsstand had served as a cultural landmark and gathering spot for residents of all ages. Sam, at 49 years old, inherited the business as the third-generation owner, embodying its rich legacy and fostering a deep connection with the neighborhood. The decision to shutter Thumbi Magazine store came as a shock to many, triggered by an instruction to reduce the magazine display area by half. This directive posed a significant challenge for Sam, prompting him to seek alternative locations for his cherished establishment. Minister Chan Chun Sing, also a member of parliament at Tanjong Pagar GRC, took proactive steps to support Sam during this transitional period. Minister Chan's involvement extended beyond mere words of encouragement. He personally accompanied Sam on a walk around the Holland Village neighborhood, scouting possible alternative locations for Thumbi Magazine store. Through this gesture, Minister Chan reaffirmed the government's commitment to preserving community heritage and supporting local businesses in navigating challenges. The Facebook post shared by Minister Chan included several images of his interaction with Sam, capturing poignant moments of solidarity and determination. One such image depicted the duo standing together at Holland Village MRT station, symbolizing their joint effort to chart a new path forward for Thumbi Magazine store. In his post, Minister Chan expressed optimism for the future, stating that efforts were underway to collaborate with relevant agencies and partners to explore viable options for Thumbi Magazine store's relocation. He emphasized the importance of collective action and community engagement in safeguarding cherished institutions like Thumbi Magazine store. The closure of Thumbi Magazine store evoked strong emotions within the Holland Village community. On the store's final day of operation, Sam was visibly moved, reflecting on the profound significance of the newsstand and the outpouring of support from loyal patrons. Despite the challenges and uncertainty, Sam remained resolute in his commitment to finding a new location for his beloved establishment. As we reflect on this heartwarming display of solidarity and perseverance, let us stand in solidarity with Sam and Thumbi Magazine Store, advocating for the preservation of community heritage and the resilience of small businesses. Together, we can ensure that the spirit of Holland Village endures, fostering a vibrant and inclusive environment for generations to come.
欢迎来到2230, 您的见识性新闻更新和鼓舞人心故事的源头。 今天我们为您带来了一则详尽报道，讲述了新加坡教育部长陈振声如何向荷兰村的Thumbi Magazine Store的老板 Periathambi Senthil Murugan 山姆伸出援手，请与我们一起探索保护社区遗产和支持本地企业的努力。别忘了点赞、分享和订阅，以获取更多令人振奋的内容。在最近的一篇 Facebook 帖子中。 新加坡教育部长陈振声分享了一则充满社区支持和韧性的感人故事。他的帖子聚焦于荷兰村的Thumbi Magazine Store的业主 Periathambi Senthil Murugan 山姆该书报摊在经营了80多年后最近关闭了大门。陈部长透露，他正在积极协助山姆寻找该标志性书报摊的替代位置。 Thumbi Magazine Store 于5月5日关闭，标志着荷兰村社区的一个时代的结束。80多年来，这家书报摊一直是文化地标和居民聚集地。 山姆今年49岁，作为第三代业主继承了这家企业，承载着其丰厚的传统，并与社区建立了深厚的联系。关闭 Thumby Magazine Store 的决定令许多人感到震惊，这是因为有指示要将杂志展示区减半，这一指示给山姆带来了重大挑战，促使他寻找真爱企业的替代地点。陈振声部长不仅仅是口头上的鼓励，而且采取了积极的步骤，在这一过渡期间支持山姆。陈部长的参与不仅仅是言传身教，他亲自陪同山姆在荷兰村社区四处走动，寻找 Thumby Magazine Store 的可能替代地点。通过这一举动，陈部长重申了政府保护社区遗产和支持本地企业应对挑战的承诺。陈振声部长分享的 Facebook 帖子包括他与山姆互动的多张照片，捕捉到了团结和决心的感人时刻。其中一张照片显示了两人站在荷兰村地铁站一起，象征着他们共同努力为 Thumby Magazine Store 开辟新道路。在他的帖子中，陈振声部长对未来表示乐观，表示正在与相关机构和合作伙伴合作，探讨 Thumby Magazine Store 的迁址可行性。他强调了共同行动和社区参与在保护像 Thumby Magazine Store 这样的珍贵机构方面的重要性。 Thumby Magazine Store 的关闭在荷兰村社区引起了强烈的情感共鸣。在商店最后一天的经营中，山姆显然受到了感动，反思了书报摊的深远意义以及忠实顾客的支持。尽管面临挑战和不确定性，山姆仍然坚定地致力于为真爱企业寻找新的地点。当我们反思这一令人感动的团结和坚韧时，让我们与山姆和 Thumby Magazine Store 一起站在一起，呼吁保护社区遗产和小企业的韧性。共同努力，我们可以确保荷兰村的精神永存，为后代打造一个充满活力和包容性的环境。